The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Each day, across our wide country, and even beyond its borders, I greet you to share a story. This time, I invite you to sit at my table for whatever meal suits the occasion. I offer you a modest banquet of several courses. For hors d'oeuvre, for example, or an aperitif before the meal, may I suggest the most delicate hint of international intrigue?
Jake, there's someone at the door.
Relax, Lily. Train conductors are hardened to lovers.
No, not the inside door. Outside the train.
What?
Clinging to the outside door. Help me. Help me to get him in.
The guy must be crazy. Look out for the door. I'm going to open it. Give me a hand. Hold tight.
Jake, can you...
I hope so. It's him or me. Either I get him in or... Here I go.
Our mystery drama, Orient Express, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Ian Martin and stars Mandel Kramer and Marion Seldes. It is sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and General Electric Citizen Band Radios. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Washington Bulletin began publishing proudly in 1800 with the birth of our capital city. For 175 years, it published uninterruptedly an independent newspaper, respected and admired for its continuity, its devotion to uncompromising faithfulness to the whole truth and nothing but. Sadly, it went under a few years ago and published no more. Its demise was just about the time of this story, though neither fact had a bearing on the other. The timing was strictly coincidental, and the year was 1969.
Jake! Jake Shaw!
My master's voice.
Yes, boss.
Jake, where the Sam Hill are you?
Right here, PM. Just stopped for a little drink.
Well, that figure.
From the water cooler.
That don't figure. Come on, get into my office. I got to talk to you.
On my way, my general. Always not to reason why. Always.
Get in and shut up. I got no time to hack around.
Your bad grammar is showing.
Never mind the way I talk. I got no time to bother about grammar right now.
Then why does that little blue pencil of yours have to be so busy revising the prose us hotshot reporters turn into you?
Oh, that's different. That has to be read in the bulletin. We got to maintain a standard. How long will it take you to pack?
Summer or winter? Sport or sincere type suit, black tie? Or...
whatever you figured be right for Berlin and points east and south.
Behind the Iron Curtain? How do I manage that?
Well, that's up to you. Here. Airline tickets, expense money, contact. You're booked on the night flight to Paris.
I thought you said Berlin.
You'll contact our European chief in Paris. He'll bring you up to date on the latest on Stepanek.
Jan Stepanek?
That's right. We want you to cover his trial. Get the full story back to us.
But, PM, he's being tried in Czechoslovakia.
That's right.
Well, would you please tell me how I'm going to get there without a visa, without a
passport? That's right. Is yours up to date?
Well, sure, but how do I get a visa for Czechoslovakia?
That's why you're going to Berlin. One reason, anyway. It's up to you how to get over or under the wall and on down to Prague.
Oh, come on, PM. What have you got against me? Why pick me to get my tail shot off? Or end up seeing red in some Russian hooscow.
I got nothing against you, Jake. I picked you because you speak German and some Czech, but mostly because you're the one guy I know I can get to take this assignment.
Well, guess again. I'm no hero.
Well, I'll top you. You guess who's in Berlin, back at the Odeon.
Lily?
How does that grab you?
No. No good. No good. Well, nice try, PM, but that's over and done with.
You too? You lit a pretty big torch, son.
Well, it burned out.
Why?
Well, two professions that don't mix. She circles the world packing them into nightclubs to hear her sing. I circle it looking for someone to sing the right tune and give me a news beat. Trouble is, we don't travel in the same circles, and they don't cross often enough. So, We just decided to split.
You could have made an honest woman out of that girl.
Why didn't you marry her?
I guess her torch didn't burn quite bright enough for that.
I'm sorry. So you're turning down the assignment?
Does a PFC thumb his nose at a chicken colonel? No. I'll take a crack at it.
Great. I wouldn't kid you. There might be some danger.
Yeah, I noticed the ticket was only one way. Auf Wiedersehen, mein Führer. See you in church.
Well, I hope not. You stay out of trouble.
What am I going looking for?
Danke, Herr Ober. Entschuldigen Sie, Fräulein. Ist dieser Platz besetzt?
Nein, aber ich muss... Jake?
Lily? I guess you'd rather be alone. Now more than ever.
No, no, please. Sit down. Have dinner with me.
An offer I can't refuse.
What are you doing in Europe?
Well, suppose I said looking for you.
Oh, please. Now, let's not start on that note.
Well, what would you consider the right one?
Old friends.
Now, that would be a switch. I'll try it on for size. What are you doing on this train? I heard you were in Berlin.
I had some business in Paris. Some thinking to do. You know I'm not fond of planes, and I had time, so I took the train. You?
Well, I had some business in Paris also.
And you have been on the train all the way? And I didn't know.
No. I flew to Bonn this morning. The planes were all booked, so I took the train. Kismet.
Yeah. You look thin.
I worry a lot. And I drink. You look tired.
I worry a lot, too.
About us?
It is not the time for us.
Never does quite seem to be, does it?
Let's not reopen old wounds. Oh, Jake, please, let's just forget an unhappy present and spend time talking about a happier past.
I don't see much future in it. But why not? Count my blessings. You're still as beautiful as ever. And every man in this dining car would give his eye teeth to be sitting in my place.
This is my compartment. Will you come in, please, Jake?
Now, there's another offer I can't refuse.
Please, don't. You know why I ask you in.
I know why I want to think you asked me.
No time for that, Jake.
There never quite is.
Oh, Liebling, forgive me. There's so much else in my head now. I can think of nothing but what I have heard about Stepanek. After all, he's my countryman, Jan. Dear, sweet, wonderful Jan. I would give my life for him if I knew how. Now, you're sure he's going to be tried?
P.M. Barnes is, and if he says a potato's a pineapple, you better believe he's right. Didn't you pick up any information on your own from your Paris contact?
No, just that he'd been arrested. What will they try him for?
Search me. It's what my paper'd like to know. My guess, he deviated.
What?
Deviated from the party line. Zigged when he should have zagged.
No, that isn't very funny.
No, it isn't, Lily. But frankly, I find it just too tough to waste any sympathy on that party.
Jan Stepanek is a Czechoslovakian. More than that, he's a patriot. As much a patriot as Masaryk or Beneš.
Well, in spite of that, he remained in Czechoslovakia.
He has a wife and children.
Oh?
And other reasons. And he is no communist.
I see. I did pick up some feedback in Paris that triggered a notion he might be a contact man for our side. Was he?
I don't know, really. But knowing Jan, I'm sure he could have been. Oh, what will they do to him if they find him guilty?
They arrested him, Lily. If they intend to bring him to trial, he'll be found guilty.
Oh, Lord, no. Oh, poor Jan. He's so kind and so gentle. And when I think of what they may be doing to him now...
All right. Now, just take it easy. Easy. If it's any comfort to you, my bet is Stepanek is dead already.
Why?
Just a hunch. It's their pattern. I mean, just look, a closed trial. Secret. Why? No defendant, just a verdict.
But then why do you bother to go to Berlin?
It's the nearest place I can get to Czechoslovakia. I'd like to get through the wall and all the way. I'd give anything to show those bums up.
I'd give anything to save Jan's life if he's still alive. Even my own life.
You love him that much, huh?
He got my family and me out of Czechoslovakia when the Germans were occupying it. Smuggled us through. I owe him my life. Oh, dear God. He can't be dead. Hold me, Jake. Hold me.
I got you.
I'm still so insecure after all the terror. But I always feel so safe in your arms. I've missed you.
I've missed you, Lily. Oh, how I've missed you, baby.
Oh.
Lily, you do love me, don't you?
Oh, I... Jake. Someone at the door.
Train conductors are hardened to lovers.
No, not the inside. The outside door.
What?
Clinging to the train on the outside. Help me. Get him in.
The guy must be crazy. Look out for the door.
I've got it. Look out now. Here he comes. All right. In you come.
Jake, the door. I can't...
I'm with you. Okay, pull. Pull.
Are you all right, mein Herr?
Yeah. Danke schön. My apologies, Fräulein, for troubling you.
Well, I should think so. What, are you crazy? Where did you come from?
Another carriage. I cannot stay long. They're searching the train. Pull the curtains. No one must see me here.
Now, wait a minute.
Please do as he says, Jake. Over the inner door.
Okay.
Forgive me. I must talk quickly. You are Lily Vardash?
Yes.
Yes. You knew Jan Stepanek when he was working in the underground?
Yes.
Would you wish to save his life?
Oh, yes.
Now, wait a minute, whoever you are.
For the sake of a man's life, spare me a moment. Fräulein Vardash, how well did you know Jan Stepanek?
Only for a short while, but long enough to love him with all my heart and never to forget his face.
You never knew he had a brother.
No.
All right, now look, that's enough. Who are you?
I am Konrad Stepanek. Jan Stepanek is my brother.
Well, what is it you want?
My brother's life. Look, these documents will buy it.
What are they?
The reason my brother has been arrested for trial.
What do they contain?
A detailed and documented exposé of the Russian rape of our country.
But how will these save Jan's life?
Quickly. We are nearly to the station and the checkpoint. If these papers are brought to Berlin and placed in the right hands, they can be exchanged for my brother's safety. Now, observe. They contain no information that is not known by the Allies, so they are of little use to them.
Why are they so important to the Russians?
Like the Chinese, they are very conscious of face. They don't mind red hands, but they do red faces. They expect to be suspected, but they don't like being caught.
Red-handed.
Yes, as you say. That is very important to them. More important than my brother's life.
I'll take them. And what do you want me to do?
Why can't you hand them over yourself?
What do you think would happen to me? Even now I am dispensable. They're on my trail, searching the train for me. But Fräulein Vardash will pass through customs, out of the corridor and into Berlin without question. She is my only chance.
And what will I do in Berlin?
A man named Hans Müller will contact you. You can trust him. The password is Phoenix. It is all arranged. I am desperate. It's the only chance. I have to risk it.
Lily, don't get mixed up in it. Oh, wait a minute.
You have my brother's life in your hands, Lily Vardash.
Oh. Close the door, Jake. He's gone.
Of all the insane...
I'll help you. Come on.
I've got it. I can manage. Lily, you are not going to do what he said.
What else can I do? What is it, Jake?
A shot. Hard to see through the steam from the brakes. There's someone running.
Is it Conrad? Open the window and see.
That steam.
It's so dark. But they're near the station lights.
Whoever it was, they got him.
Was it... Conrad?
It looked like him.
Is he dead?
I don't know.
We're in a station. Go quickly, Jake. Find out.
All right. What about the papers?
I'll take care of the papers. Trust me, Jake. I'll see they're taken care of.
What would any good adventure melodrama be without the papers? Of course, their appearance is only the beginning, usually. For the essence of the excitement is not the papers themselves, but what they are about, and how many people are desperate enough to want them. Well, no doubt we shall start to find out about that when I return shortly with Act Two. Long, sleek lines of the Orient Express glisten, a pattern of rain reflecting the station lamps. Orient Express. Oh, perhaps I hadn't mentioned, that's the train Jake and Lily are on. For in its day, you know, there was more than one Orient Express. The fabled one that ran south from Paris to end in Istanbul, Turkey, and the northern one, as mysterious and storied in its own way. The one we are traveling on from Paris to Berlin. The train to which Jake is hurrying back rapidly and surreptitiously at this moment.
Lily, what are you doing on the platform?
Looking for you, Jake. You were gone so long. What happened?
Come on. Too many guys and too many uniforms. We don't want to call attention to ourselves. Let's get back on the train in a hurry.
But was it Conrad?
Yes.
And?
Climb aboard quickly while they're too busy to notice us. So far, so good.
Conrad, was he shot?
Yes, killed, I'm afraid.
Oh, why?
Now, the best I could gather, trying to keep out of sight in case someone took a pot shot at me, was for resisting arrest.
But killed by
whom? Now, there you have me. Look, Berlin's divided into four parts, so there were Russian, French, English, and American uniforms, to say nothing of some plainclothesmen.
But we're not in Berlin yet.
No, the train evidently was flagged down.
Why?
Well, I'd say to trap Conrad Stepanek and or the papers. Which leads me to something else I'd like to say.
What?
They're too hot to handle. Now, let's turn them over, Lily.
I can't.
Why not? If and when they search this train, as they've already started to do, how can you hide them?
I told you. I said I'd take care of them.
I wish I had never heard of Stepanek or his brother or the damn papers. All I want to do is make love, not war.
For some of us, Jake, it seems the war never stops.
Brace yourself. We're about to be invaded.
It won't be the first time a Czech has had to suffer that.
Now, last chance, baby. Do we level or not?
I know nothing. That's what I shall say. Will you betray me?
If I could have just one look at what they're all about.
No, it's impossible. The envelope is sealed with wax and a signet ring.
Oh, you are a stubborn lady.
You of all people should know that, Jake.
Open up, special police.
Well, Jake, will you go with me?
I sure wish I knew where we were going.
Open the door or we break it down.
I am Comrade Captain Grigori, Soviet Special Police. This is the compartment of Lily Vardash.
That's right.
Who are you?
Jake Shaw, Washington Bulletin, reporter.
A newspaper man, no?
A newspaper man, yes.
My country does not hold a very high opinion of your so-called profession.
Well, that makes us even. My profession doesn't hold such a hot opinion of your so-called country.
What are you doing in this woman's compartment?
Come on, Captain Grigori, is one man of the world to another?
Mr. Shaw is an old friend of mine. We met by chance in the dining car, and he had just seen me back to my compartment when the train stopped and all this excitement happened.
Mm.
What is going on?
Everyone on this train must be searched and all the baggage.
But this isn't customs yet.
We are empowered by the East German Socialist Republic to stop this train. Newspaper man, you will come with me. My men will search you and your baggage, Fräulein.
Who is it?
Jake.
Oh. Oh, thank heaven you're all right.
I'm fine. Oh. They tore my compartment apart and me, but I have nothing to hide. Now, what about you?
Close the door. As you see.
Oh, boy, what a mess. Just like mine.
They turned everything upside down. They ripped things apart.
They found?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Not a thing.
What did you do with them? Eat them?
No.
Throw them away?
No.
Then where are they?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Yes. And what's more, I'm going to...
No, you're not. This is my problem.
Lily, you're not going to throw me off.
But the train did.
Did what?
Threw you off your feet and into my arms.
Well, I never needed a train to do that. It happened the first time we met.
Oh, let's go back to that, Jake, and forget everything else for the little time we've left together.
Oh, no, Lily. I'm not letting you get away this time. I'm going to check into the same hotel with you.
All right.
And I want to look at those papers before you get rid of them.
All right. That might be arranged eventually, but not now.
Why not?
Let's call it a matter of priorities. Haven't we better things to do for this little while when we know we're completely alone?
Like what?
You never had to be asked before.
What are you up to?
Let's find out. Like the American saying, why don't you look this gift horse in the mouth?
Oh, have you got it wrong? I shouldn't even be doing this. Want me to help you get settled?
In my hotel room. I've been living in it for the last 2 months.
All right. I'll go on down the hall, unpack, shower, and be back in time to escort you to your late show.
All right. Don't be too long.
I won't. I'll get you there for your first number.
Fräulein Weidersch.
How did you get in my room?
Easily.
What are you doing here?
Waiting for you, obviously. Do you know me?
No, I never saw you before in my life. Wait. Is your name Miller?
Correct. I'm sorry about the gun, but one has to be careful in these matters.
Also very prompt.
Your train was late.
Yes. You have a first name?
Natürlich. Hans.
And there was something else.
The word. Phoenix.
Yes. You know that Conrad...
We have been notified. A pity. The chance we all take. But you have the papers.
Not with me. I'm not a child.
Of course. I must warn you, the man with you is under surveillance by us.
He will do you no good, Herr Miller. He is almost as anxious as you to know where they are.
Why?
For his own reasons. He's very interested in my welfare.
The Herr Shaw is in love with you?
That is beside the point. You deal with me.
I want you to understand how important this is. I will stop at nothing to get these papers. I do not wish you to have any illusions.
And Conrad said you could be trusted implicitly.
In international intrigue, no one can be trusted implicitly.
But that makes it a little difficult to strike a bargain, Herr Miller.
Not at all. There is always the arrangement of mutual benefit. It remains only to find it. I have Stepanek. You have the papers. How do we make the exchange?
Suppose I ask the questions for a change.
As you wish.
You can promise me Stepanek is alive?
Of course.
I can see him?
That will take a day or so. But it is possible, yes.
Then there's your bargain. You show me Stepanek and I will arrange to give you the papers.
I think it can be arranged.
When?
You will have to leave that up to me. This far I can be trusted. But you?
In a matter of mutual benefit, why not? Beyond that, Jan Stepanek is my friend, and I would give anything to save his life.
Including your own?
I don't think that will be necessary.
I sincerely hope not. So, for once I feel I can break my rule. I will contact you before the end of your engagement. Tell no one. I feel I can trust you implicitly.
Well, that's most gallant of you, Herr Miller. But I prefer the unvarnished truth.
The truth?
This time you have no choice.
As you say, Fräulein, I have no choice. This time.
One more encore, Fräulein Wardash. They come to the nightclub only to hear you.
I'm sorry, I can't sing anymore.
Hey, but this is your last night.
Yes, I have many things to do and a plane to catch tomorrow morning.
But you were magnificent as always and will return soon to the Odeon Café, I hope.
I shall be delighted to, Herr Lanz. Now I must change.
Oh, there is a gentleman waiting for you in your dressing room.
Herr Shaw?
No, he is on the... I forgot. The Herr Shaw is on the phone and he says it's urgent.
Why didn't you tell me right away?
Well, in my excitement, I forgot. I will have the call put through to your dressing room.
No. I'll take it on the wall phone backstage there.
So, yes. That is the one he is holding on.
Dankeschön. Hello?
Lily, where have you been?
The manager forgot to tell me you were on the line. Aren't you meeting me here?
You wait for me. I'm calling from a phone booth on the Kurfürstendamm. I'll be there in about 10 minutes, but listen to me carefully. Can I talk to you safely?
I think so.
All right, now listen. I don't know what you've been up to the last few days, and I still don't know what happened to those papers. But let me tell you something. I've just had information that they're worth a hell of a lot more than they were set up to be. Don't do anything to let them out of your hands.
What is in them, Jake?
I'll tell you as soon as I get there. But I'm warning you, don't let them out of your hands.
Jake, wake up. Jake!
Oh. Anything wrong, Fräulein Wallert?
No, I hope not.
But you look so concerned.
Perhaps I am not used to having a man hang up on me.
Well, then, may I escort you to your dressing room?
No, that's quite all right. I can manage very well alone.
Guten Abend, Fräulein.
Herr Müller.
Once again with gun in hand. Unfortunately, circumstances dictate caution. Please to come in quietly and close the door.
Did Jake hang up in haste? Or did a hand stifle him from talking and other hands hang up the phone for him? Is the smiling and ubiquitous Herr Müller to be trusted at all? And will Lily stick to her side of the bargain now that Jake has warned her not to? Like a good soup being prepared to be served, the plot thickens. We'll be ready to serve it shortly when I return with Act 3. Now, if you're all ready to sit down and resume our interrupted meal, the soup, piping hot, is ready to serve and enjoy. And with it, our story, simmering through the first two acts, is ready for the final one. So without further ado, I might say, mesdames et messieurs, vous êtes servis. Or perhaps more correctly, meine Herren und Damen, the repast is ready.
Did you think I had forgotten our little rendezvous, Fräulein?
I'd hope not. But you come at the 11th hour, Herr Müller.
It's quite so. You plan to leave Berlin tomorrow by American army plane. A party of two or possibly three at midday. Yourself, Herr Shaw, and one other.
You are well informed.
It is my business. Well, shall we go?
Where?
To see Stepanek.
He is still alive, then?
Of course. You will see for yourself. Shall we go?
But I am waiting for someone who expects to pick me up.
Herr Shaw, I presume?
Yes.
I don't think we should wait for him.
Why? You haven't done...
My dear Fräulein, you will remember that our pact is between us alone.
But you can't hurry me, Herr Müller. May I remind you that the papers are in my hands alone.
There is something else in your hands alone. Stepanek's life.
But...
Now. Or never. Which shall it be?
Now.
You see, Fräulein, this time it is you who has no choice. Welcome to East Berlin, Fräulein Wardasch.
We're beyond the wall.
The labyrinth of subterranean passages and underground rooms we have passed through brought us from west to east. A maze no stranger could trace.
Is that supposed to be a threat to make me afraid?
Not afraid, Fräulein. Just careful. Very careful.
I promise you, I will be.
Very well. It is too much to hope, I suppose, that you have the papers with you.
I told you before, Herr Müller, I am not a child.
To that I agree. Very well. Now you will see what you came to see. This way. After you... You are sure you can recognize Stepanek?
Quite sure.
He has changed, you know. People do in his position. You must be prepared for that.
What have you done to him?
What has he brought on himself? You are ready?
Yes. Ready.
Sehr gut. So...
Jan Stepanek. Jan, what have they done to you?
Is that you, little Lily? Yeah. Oh, you find it hard to recognize me? Of course, a man loses 50 pounds, makes a difference. A man lies abandoned in a stone box, scarcely room to move. The muscles grow slack, the flesh wastes. How much does a skeleton look like a man?
Oh, yeah, you're so sick.
Not only the body, but the soul.
Are you really the Jan Stepanek I knew?
Remember the scar and the broken arm in Trebec? These fingers from that awful night in Munich. Lily, Lily, help me, please. That I could bear, but not this. Not this.
Jan, listen to me. It's all behind you. I have your papers. They can be exchanged for your life. There's nothing to fear anymore. I'll arrange the exchange with Miller, and you'll be free. Jan, listen to me. Look at me. Believe me. Lift up your head and look into my eyes. Hope is not gone. Let me see your eyes.
Lily.
Jake.
Oh, Lily, thank the Lord you're here. I've been going out of my mind the last few hours. Where have you been?
Where have you been?
Somebody zapped me in the telephone booth. Dumped me in the Oder or the Elbe, I don't know which. Anyway, it was cold and wet enough to bring me to before I drowned. I headed straight for the Odeon, but the manager there told me you'd gone back to your hotel. I got here, found you weren't. Changed my clothes, talked the manager into letting me wait for you here. Now, that's me. Now you, Lily. Did you go to meet Stepanek?
Or what passes for him.
What about the papers? You didn't make the exchange?
No, not yet. I've arranged for it tomorrow morning.
Now, look, Lily. Outside of you, that's the other reason I've been going out of my mind. Those papers, they're not what they're set up to be.
I have suspected that for a long time.
Now, listen to me. Just before I called you and I got the stiff arm, I'd been with an old chum who has a pipeline into army brass. He told me that they are blowing their tops because some joker had hooked a complete breakdown on the weaknesses and strengths of NATO. Complete figures. On troop dispositions, defense plans, nuclear capabilities, the whole works. Lily, not for nobody. I mean, not for nobody. Can we take a chance of that report falling into the wrong hands?
It's all right, Jake. There will be no exchange.
But what about, you know...
Jake, how fast can we get out of Berlin?
Lily, what is it, baby?
Everything, Jake, everything. I'm heart sick and I'm weary, and for the first time in my life, I'm scared. Or maybe it's just that I would just as soon be dead. How fast can we get away?
Well, as long as the papers are safe, we head on out. That army plane is still at our disposal. Just one call.
Then let's go, quickly.
All right, on the double. What about Stepanek?
Stepanek? Stepanek doesn't matter anymore.
Okay, Lily?
I'm here.
You could have let me go to the Teufelhaben gate and taken a stab at trying to get Stepanek through.
It's no use. I'd have gone myself, but he wouldn't have been there. It was only a trap.
A little backup might have been arranged. It might have been worth a chance.
A chance not worth taking. Let's not talk about it anymore. It makes me sick.
Because you feel you've run out on a friend?
Stepanek.
Well, who else?
That wasn't Stepanek I met tonight.
What? Well, the scars he showed you... the things he knew. Who was it?
No, that's one of the things that are making me sick inside. What men can do to their fellow men for power or money or gain. Merlo, that lonesome tote, so secure that the pitiful thing he showed me was so broken in spirit and body that no one could recognize him. But I knew. I knew.
How can you be so sure?
I think your hunch was right, Jake. I think Jan was dead long before this thing began. I knew it in the train. You see, I was sure that Jan never had a brother.
Well, then why?
Because, don't you see, I couldn't take any chances. In case Jan, dear wonderful Jan, was still alive.
And now?
Now I know. Because whatever else can be disguised, you cannot hide the eyes or what lies in them. This man's eyes were brown and Jan's were blue. The eyes I saw were not Jan's. His were as blue and tender and deep as a mountain lake.
Lily. Lily, I hate to bring this up now, but the papers. You're sure, are you, that...
We're being followed.
I've known it for some time. It was one reason I kept you talking.
What are we going to do?
Just hold on to your hat and pray the Marines arrive as scheduled.
What do you mean?
Around the next bend, I think. Our territory and a roadblock. I asked for it just in case.
How do we get through it?
We'll make it, don't worry. But I don't think our friends will care to chance it.
Geronimo!
Geronimo!
Let her rip, we're through.
What was that?
A little gadget known as a flamethrower. Guaranteed to stop even King Kong dead in his tracks. Lily?
Yes, Jake.
Now that we're safely out of it all and on our way to Paris, something occurs to me.
What's that, Jake?
That vivid description of Stepanak's eyes. How well do you have to know a man to describe his eyes so vividly?
Oh, very well.
Enough to be in love with him?
In love with Jan Stepanak. The man who saved me and my whole family from death? How could I fail to be in love with him? I remember back to the time when my whole world spun like a child's top at his slightest wish. His every look, his smallest command. I would have lied for him, stolen for him, begged for him. And if he'd asked me to jump off a mountain blindfold or dive into the deepest ocean with chains of lead around my waist, I'd have done it for a smile from that sad, grave face. And his eyes, I will never forget, no matter what they did to him. Dauntless, unafraid, clear, holding only one prisoner in them. Me, Jane. The most willing of slaves. In love. I loved him with all my heart.
Well, I guess that puts me right in my place again.
Why? That was so long ago. That was long before I ever knew you.
Lily, no man in love with a woman wants to hear how much she loved another man, no matter when it was.
Oh, are you so sure, Jake? Remember, Jan was, somewhere in his 20s, and I was 11, going on 12.
Now you ought to be ashamed. Putting me on the rack like that, you ought to be ashamed.
No, Jake. Just let me remember all the good things about Jan.
Of course. I have a terrible nerve.
This time, don't retire quietly from the field, Jake. I've learned a big lesson. Nothing is more important than how people feel for people. And love is worth more than any career. And, Jake, I love you. There is no one else. There never has been.
That makes two of us, Lily. Two of us who just plain ought to be one.
Oh,
honey.
Oh, Jake.
Nice, hmm?
Oh, so nice.
Honey, just one thing. Honest, Lily, I hate to bring it up. But there is all sorts of brass waiting for us when we land in Paris. Where are those damn papers?
Hmm? Oh, the papers. Well, when you were finding out what happened to Conrad at the first station, I just addressed the envelope to myself and mailed them in the station postbox to me at the hotel in Berlin.
For Pete's sake, did they arrive before we took off?
No.
Well, then they're still there. We'll have to turn back and pick them up.
Why, Jake?
Well, after all the waves I've set in motion and the flak I've stirred up, we can't turn up in Paris without them.
Oh, don't worry, Jake. This is my week for thinking of almost everything. They will be in Paris almost as soon as we are.
How do you figure?
Well, I did put a return address on them. If not picked up within 5 days, please return to Mr. Jake Shaw, care of American Embassy, Paris, France.
Oh, Lily, Lily, you know you are a genius. But what do you mean, almost everything?
Well, I can't do it all. You are the one who has to make a completely honest woman of me.
You mean at last? Well, why not? You've just proved to me that you're the only one who could have made me an honest man.
From soup to the sweet course, in one easy act. I hope you enjoyed the fare tonight, that it was to your taste. I might mention that the devious Herr Muller and some of his companions met an untimely end at that roadblock. So ends our meal. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll be back shortly. Before we finish our coffee and say farewell, any questions? Lily and Jake? Yes, they were quietly married in Paris before returning to the United States. Jake is no longer a reporter. His book, The Second Time Around, or Czechoslovakia, Twice Raped, was the beginning of his career as a writer of contemporary history. Lily no longer sings, except, of course, with the older children, Jan and Jake Jr., and to the baby, who hasn't been named yet. On the other side of the curtain, all is silence. Men make their own prisons, and only man can set himself free. Our cast included Marion Seldes, Mandel Kramer, Hans Conried, Leon Janney, and Earl Hammond. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
Quickly, Jane, hold that basin while I sponge his wounds.
She's a fiend. A fiend incarnate. I won't live through the night.
Nonsense, man, nonsense. You've nothing but scratches.
She stabbed me. Barely missed my jugular vein. I'm bleeding to death.
Courage, Richard. You'll survive.
But my arm. She sank her teeth into it.
We'll get the doctor as soon as we can. Just be calm.
Calm? She sucked my blood and said she would drain my heart.
Surely after this murderous attack, Grace Poole would be removed from the household. But weeks later, I saw the retreating form of the woman in gray and black starting up the attic stairs. Only while she was still on the stairway, from overhead, I heard...
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by General Electric Citizen Band Radios and Buick Motor Division. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.